to another video on how to install on how the CG fix here. We're going to be installing an aftermarket intake on our Acura TSX 2004. This also fits from 2004 to 2008. So we're going to be installing this intake today. I'm going to show you every step, every tools you need. So guys, if you like this video, by the end of the video, make sure you like, subscribe to this video, share. And any questions you guys got, just comment down below. If you guys want anything done to your TSX and you always want to put it, you want me to put it in my car, I'll install it just so you guys can see it.
Alright guys, so these are the basic tools we're going to be using today to install the short ram intake. I'm going to put down below in the descriptions each individually so you guys don't miss anything and you guys can use the same tools I use so you can install your short ram intake on the Acura TSX. Alright guys, and this is what comes in the kit for the pH tuning. So you got the filter, you got some piping, you got the clamps here, and then you got the rubber hoses. So guys, and then you also got a mount right over here. So this is all you get with the pH, all eBay to short ram intake. Alright guys, so I'm going to go down on basic on the bolts you would have to take out. So you're going to want to take out these four right over here. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 to take this cap off the filter, the top part. We're going to be taking these clamps out because you're not going to use this anymore. So these bases are going to hook up to your aftermarket piping. And then we're going to go and undo this right here, take it out. Make sure that this sensor, you take it out first. You do not want to ruin this sensor, guys. So take this sensor out. You're going to have to put this sensor on the aftermarket intake. Alright guys, so once you take these four bolts off, basically this pops out, you're going to take this filter out, and you're not going to need it anymore. That's a brand new one, so I just replaced it a week ago, dirty in the bottom, but this thing is brand new 2 weeks ago. Yeah, put that to the side. So once you grab this off, now we're going to get the working done here. We're going to take it off right on this clamp right here, and then take these clamps out, because this part you are going to need for the other one. So once you've taken out this bolt right over here on the throttle body, you're going to take this to the side, undo this right here, take this hose out. Oh, I might need both hands for this. There you go. It was easier to take it out from this side, and then this whole piece just comes out. There you go guys, that's the top part of the air intake to take out. So remember these four bolts right here, take it out, this hose and this clamp right over here is loosening it up from the throttle body. Take that out. Make sure you don't forget about the sensor. You are going to need that sensor on the other intake. All right guys, as you can see, it's all filthy. For me, I'm going to keep this part because I'm going to try to put the short ram intake in here, since I don't got a cold air intake that goes down to original one goes. So I'm gonna leave this, try to do as much as possible to keep this here. Now I'm gonna have to cut this right here so I can make it fit. But yeah guys, let's get this installing done. Let's get start taking this out and then start putting the other intake in. Well guys, if you didn't know, this is my best friend here, David, my secondary mechanic. I'm kind of stuck taking out this rubber hose right here, so he's gonna help me out. There you go, voila, man. That's what you need a best friend for. Yeah. Alright, guys, so once that sensor is inside the aftermarket intake, we're gonna go and plug this in right here. Oh, wrong way. Alright, that's plugged tight in there. So you don't want to don't tighten nothing yet, actually. Actually, I gotta put the clamp right here also. But don't tighten anything up, because in case you gotta move things around and adjust. You know, when you gotta adjust things here, to make sure everything fits. So just basically just prop everything up, and then install it once everything, you know, fits correctly. But as you can see, this kit actually brought this line, which is pretty long. It goes right there, and look how long that is, guys. So we definitely don't want that. We don't want any restrictions on the air. So we're gonna cut this in half, Same thing with the other one. Same thing with this one, guys. As you can see, way too long. So we're gonna cut these in half and then install them in. So while I take a break doing this, we got my friend David right over here. Where is David?
It's a 1986 CJ7 Renegade.
All right, guys. So if you guys want to see that Renegade run this summer, yeah, give a comment down below. If you guys want to be interested in seeing this Jeep get out of here, we got to take this whole mess out, take it right out. It's going to be ready by the summer. Going to car shows, guys. This is what we do here. Once you're all set, this is what it looks like. So we had to do a couple modifications, but we had to leave like the regular hoses from the car itself. We had to leave them there. We had to cut some holes because there was way too much holes on here. And obviously you have to keep this for the coolant. You know, I didn't want them running in this rubber thing, so I've just left that on, obviously. So yeah, tighten everything up, guys, and look how beautiful it looks, guys. All right, guys, so this is how it sounds inside the vehicle. It sounds beautiful, guys. So once you put that intake, you'll be well satisfied, guys. Yeah, it sounds beautiful, guys. Beautiful. Love the sound. Love the sound, guys. Hit that like button, guys. This was definitely a success. Guys, so if you like this video, make sure you subscribe, like this video, share it, comment, hit the notification button so you can get my next videos coming up every single week on Thursday. I'll be posting up a video. So if you guys want anything done on your TSX that you would like in your TSX, make sure you comment down below and I'll install it in my car so you see how it looks in my vehicle so you hopefully put it on yours. So guys, make sure you follow, subscribe again, like this video, guys. Appreciate all the support, guys, all those subscribers I got right now. It means a lot, guys. So I'll see you guys soon on the next video. Take care. Peace. Alright guys, and just so you know, I traded my Acura TSX stock rims for these, which are beautiful. XXR rims, guys. I can't believe these guys actually traded my regular TSX stock wheels for these, guys. They're not in the best shape, but they're gonna be there. You know, they just have a little, they have a little curb rash right over here. I just tripped, by the way. But yeah, they have a little curb rash right here, you know, a couple of them. But other than that, you cannot beat it. Guys, so let me know if you guys like these rims on the Acura TSX or should I change them. Let me know your feedback on them.